Week 10, which is doing the evangelism. Okay, I'm looking to settle down. You tell me already by not talking. Okay, so in the previous lecture, we talked about the longitudinal wave, longitudinal standing, as well as the transverse standing. We have seen using sleep here for both. Do you want to see the book? Yeah, I think so.
Okay, so now what we are going to do is we are going to discuss in greater detail the transverse standing wave in the string.
Okay, like that of a slinky, you can actually form standing wave in the string, like either string instruments. Still very okay, for a string, if you want to set up a standing wave, for those who play guitar, what you will do is you will
strike somewhere in the string. Okay, if I were to do it in the middle, you'll find that the wave right will be sent out to the two fixed ends, which I call the notes, and then get reflected. Okay, so if I take the dotted wave that you see here to be at time t equals 0, when I first created the wave, then half a period later, the wave will look like that of the continuous waveform that you see here. So that is a standing wave. If I fix the length of the string, then L, and let it be L, then you'll find that the wavelength in this case is actually 2L, or L equals to half lambda.
Okay, remember in the last lecture we talked about distance between successive notes is exactly half a lambda. So in this case, when I set a standing wave like that, you see on the screen, okay, the wavelength will be 2L,
two times the length of the string. And because it's a wave, so I can use the velocity of the wave, v equals to f lambda. From there, I can get out, I can get the frequency of the wave.
So in order to get this standing wave, if you are using slinky, right, you need to do it at the correct frequency. Okay, the frequency that you vibrate must be such that it's equal to the velocity of the wave divided by 2L. So it's dependent on the distance of the
string. If you were to go to a higher frequency, which we call mode 2, just now that one was mode 1. Mode 2 is second harmonics. For those who do music, or we call it the first overtone, the length in this case will be exactly the wavelength.
Okay, because it's mode 2, so I call it lambda 2. So this is the second harmonic wavelength.
And from the velocity equation, I can get the second harmonic frequency, which is V over L. Okay, I can go on to get the mode 3, if I even vibrate even faster, increase the frequency. At the correct frequency, you'll find that I will see another standing wave, where in this case, the wavelength, right, the L will be 3 over 2 lambda, so the wavelength is actually 2 over 3. I can also get the frequency of the third one, which is 3V over 2 lambda.
Can I go to mode 4? Is it possible? 5? So what's the largest number? So actually, depending on how fast you can go, there is no limit to it. Are you okay? You want to see the different harmonics? Okay. You want to try? Or we ask someone else? Anybody want to try? How about the girls?
Distance 2 meters apart, 2 meters. 2 meters. 2 meters.
Okay, I want to fix the length of the string. I will fix at 2 meters. That's not 2 meters. You know the length you have been doing? Two times of that. Is that 2 meters?
Yes.
Yes? No. That looks like about 4 meters. Half of that. Okay, so now you will start with slow frequency. Okay, when you're at the correct frequency, how do you know? When you get the correct frequency, you all should see this one. One loop. If I ask you to increase the frequency further, at the correct frequency where you get E over L, you will see two loops. And then the frequency. So what I want you to do is, because this sneaky, I think last lecture I brought a plastic one, not so durable. So today is a metal one. And because it's quite heavy, so I'm asking them to do it on the floor. And instead of going up and down, we'll go left and right. Okay, so Connor, you will send away. Okay, frequency is not right. Can you say no standing away? So he's going to slowly increase his frequency. Now it's too fast.
Lower your frequency.
Can you see? Mode 1, first harmonic. One loop. Okay, now slowly increase the frequency until you see two loops. Can you see two loops? Can you see an empty note and another empty note there? So this is the second harmonic. So I'm going to ask you to go higher frequency. Okay, let's see whether they can do third harmonic.
Okay, I promised Slinky, right? So I got them new Slinky. So you can pick the color. Choose one. Choose one. What color?
So you can see that the number can go on and on. Okay, if with your fixed length. So now, there's a checkpoint on page 8 of the lecture notes. I want to ask you to form a general formula for N harmonics. Okay, given a fixed length, this one they were standing at 2 meters apart, right? So the length is fixed. At both ends, I let the length be L. What are the wavelengths and the allowed frequency for N harmonics? So they must read at the right frequency. Okay, then you can have the N harmonics. If your frequency is for the 3 harmonics, then you will see 5 loops. And so on. So I'm going to give you 1 minute, you work out what is the expression in terms of N as well as L. Thank you. most of you are done. We need to see pattern.
Okay, let's take a look at mode 1.
If you refer to the previous page of your lecture note.
Okay, when it's mode 1, n equals to 1, l will be half lambda, or lambda over 2. When it's mode 2, n equals to 2, l equals to lambda, or 2l over, 2 lambda over 2. When n equals to 3, l is 3 lambda over 2. So when it's n, what is the l in terms of lambda? It will be n lambda over 2. So from there, you get a wavelength. Okay,
so it's not that difficult, right? So firstly, you deduce
your L, because you can see the pattern there
in terms of the wavelength. So if it's n harmonics, it will be just n over 2 lambda n. So I get my wavelength. Okay, after you have your wavelength, then the rest is very simple. Use V equals to F lambda, velocity of the wave.
So from there, I get the frequency. So the general equation is nV over 2L. With this formula, I wouldn't expect you to memorize. You just need to draw the loop and then see for yourself. Usually for A-level questions, they wouldn't go beyond more than 500. Okay, usually the lower one.
But there's an example two. Can I give you some time to do it now? You're asked to find what is the frequency for this mode of vibration. And then you are asked what other lower frequencies are possible.
Because you're given that the notes, right, are 0.4 meters apart. Okay, between this and the two notes is exactly half a wavelength. The length of the wire is 1.2 meters. So if I take 1.2 divided by 0.4, that will give me 3. So I should see 3 loops of 3 segments.
It will be good to draw a diagram.
Okay, so from here, we can see very clearly there are 1.2 is 1.5 lambda, because there are 3 loops.
And if I can find out the wavelength,
which is 0.8, 2 times 0.4, I should be able to work out the frequency given the velocity given. So frequency is about 375 hertz. Okay, then they ask what are the other lower frequencies. How many are there? 2, very good, 2, because this is the third harmonic. Okay, the next one will be 2 loops, and the lowest one, of course, will be 1 loop.
The diagram is optional, but you're encouraged to draw. Can I move on? Oh. Okay, so next one. So there are two other lower frequencies of the standing wave that can be set up. The first one, I started off with the lowest frequency, the fundamental frequency, which is the first harmony. That will be 1 to 5 hertz, because the wavelength here will be 2 times the L. Because you have only 1 loop, right? So that is note to note. That is exactly half number. So the wavelength is larger, therefore the frequency is smaller. So that's why if you recall this now, when we did the demo, right, it started off with low frequency. You see the first loop. Then we go higher and higher, the end of the second loop. So that is actually 2 times of the first frequency. The second harmonic frequency is 250. Then if you take a look at the third harmonic frequency, it's actually 3 times that of the fundamental frequency, the first harmonic. So actually for n harmonics, it's just n of n1.
Okay, so with that, I'm done with the example on stationary wave in the string. Now we are going to move on to another type of stationary wave, but using microwave.
Okay, the setup here is similar to that of the sound wave that you see in the previous lecture. Okay, but instead of a speaker generates sound wave, right? I need a different generator. This is a microwave generator. So it will send out microwave, and then I need a reflector. Because to get a standing wave, I need 2 identical waves. So I have a source here producing the incoming wave, then it will get reflected by the metal plate. I'll get the other wave that is going in opposite direction, and I'm identical. So when these 2 overlap, there is a chance of getting standing wave. But it's not that simple. You need to try and error to decide where you put the position of the metal plate. Because if you put it closer, let's say you put it here, the standing wave is not set up. Because this is the position that is not a note. So you need to shift the metal plate. So how do you know whether a standing wave is set up? You need a detector. Okay, so this is a microwave detector. From a microwave detector, you can tell what is the strength of the signal. So you, at the start, you put the metal plate here, then you put your detector. You move your detector around until you detect 0 signal. That is where your note is. Okay? If let's say it remains 0, what does it mean? Does it the same way you will be? You're very lucky. First round you get. But let's say you put it there, at first it's 0, then the signal increases. Then that's what? The same way is not yet formed. Because this is not a note yet. Because a note, the displacement should be permanently 0. Then what do? You will have to move the metal plate. Okay, so you try and error, you move it slightly nearer, and then you use the detector and move around until you get 0 signal. Hold there for a while, see whether the signal stays 0. If it stays 0, then it's the standing wave setup. Okay? So although the diagram looks so simple, the standing wave setup, but it's not all the time. So you will be trying this next year when you come back in the lab. Okay, you'll be setting up standing wave.
Okay, so bear this in mind, you need to try to shift the position of the reflector.
Okay, with that, I'm done with traverse of the signal wave. Okay, now I'm going to longitudinal standing wave.
The only longitudinal wave is sound wave. So we are talking about sound standing waves. So I'm going to show you a video.
In the video, right? This tube that you see here is just a plastic tube. It has a name called Coulomb's tube. Because Coulomb is from another experiment, so that's why his name was after him. The tube, as you can see, is about a meter long. Let me explain to you what it is. This is a speaker. A speaker is connected to the generator. So this generator will produce a signal to the speaker, and sound of different frequency is being transmitted through this tube. So it's adjusting the frequency. So this is the correct frequency for a standing wave, and that is the frequency. Okay, those three main characters. So this is the second harmonic. Now it's going to adjust the frequency some more. Usually when the frequency is not right, there isn't any standing wave. Then when the frequency is correct, you will see the third move. So this is the third harmonic. And the frequency is three times that of the first F1. And you recall F1 to sound was 119. So this is the third harmonic. So you can keep increasing by tuning the generator, because the generator will produce sound, will produce electrical signal, which is connected to your speaker. Speaker will send out sound of different frequency.
I make the sound very soft. Actually, you can see the speaker sending out the sound. Can you hear the sound? Yeah, so that is the sound wave that the speaker is producing. Okay, this one have different end condition. Okay, so that one, I'll talk about it later. Okay, so that's all. Oh yeah, I want to ask one question. Okay, let's go back to the video.
Okay, at this point, you can see that a standing wave is formed, right? I have a question for you that I want you to discuss. These are fine powders that are put inside the Coulomb's tube. What will happen is that when a sound signal is produced, it will cause an air column inside the tube to vibrate. Okay? So the vibration of the molecule actually causes the displacement of this fine powder. So you cannot use something heavy, you cannot use something very light. So over this position, you can see there are a lot of powders gathering here. Over the other one also. So my question is this a node or an empty node? Okay, I repeat. This position, where there is a lot of powder gathering here, is it a node or an empty node? When displacement node or empty node, turn the button to the next thing. And see whether you have to respond. Okay, a show of hands. How many of you say it's empty note? How do you say no? They don't respond. I have that to say. Only my class is responding. It's for eight. How about the rest? How many of you say empty note? S6. How many say empty note? Anyone? S6. Not empty note. How many of you say it's a no? Can't tell how many exactly. Okay, I'm going to show you the next slide. This is a simplified diagram of what you saw just now. Okay, I have a tube here, so this is a Coulomb's tube. The other end, I can choose to have a closed end or open end. I mean, if it's a closed end, could I put a stopper here? So this becomes closed when it's fixed, because the molecule can't oscillate. Okay, then the speaker here, this is a small piece of cloth that can oscillate. So this is an open end, free end. So this one is where the molecules are oscillating. Okay, then this is a topped dust, which is similar to the fine powder.
So I'm going to show you an animation. I need to go back to the previous slide. End slide show. Sorry. Then remember we said that the sound signal, right, actually caused the air columns to oscillate. Okay, you can see that
when the sound wave is being generated, it will cause the air molecules to oscillate. The air molecules will oscillate most at the entry node, but because of the movement of the air molecules, it actually pushes the fine powder away. So the position whereby you see very little or hardly any fine powder, that is where the entry node is. And the position whereby you have a lot of powder being collected, that is the position where the air molecules are not moving. Because it's not moving, and therefore it's a node.
So that's now where you saw a lot of powder collected. That is actually a node. So I can, for this tube, work out the wavelength. Since I only have a node and an antinode, right? And the distance between successive nodes is exactly half a lambda, so this will be a quarter lambda. So if I let the length of the tube be L, then the wavelength will be 4L. And if you were to sketch the displacement time graph for mode 1, it will look similar to that of a transverse wave. The only difference is for longitudinal wave, you can take to the right as positive and to the left as negative. So you get a standing wave that looks like this. So if you're asked to sketch the standing wave, that is how it will look like. Okay, I'm going to show you an applet. If you turn to page 10 of your lecture notes, at the bottom, you can see the link to this applet. Okay, over here, right, to get the condition similar to one given in your lecture notes on page 10, I'm going to choose, okay, this is the form of the tube. I can have both sides open. So this is the one that you're seeing now, okay, where there is nothing to stop the vibration of the molecule, so both sides are free end. I can choose one side open. So this is similar to the one in your lecture notes. But bear in mind the closed end, in this animation here, in this applet, is different, opposite to the closed end that I give you in your lecture notes. Okay? So it's the other way around. Huh? So whatever you see here, it should be the other way around. Okay, what does it mean? If it's at the closed end, okay, this side here, you can see the molecule is not moving, right? So the displacement is zero. So you need to sketch this graph on page 10. Okay, where the closed end is, the displacement will be zero. Okay? Where the open end is, you can see that this is a free end, so the molecules are free to oscillate. This will be exactly an empty node. Okay, so a standing wave is formed. So if the frequency is not correct, that means you won't get an empty node here. Then that is not a standing wave. So you need to adjust the frequency such that for this length of the tube, it is exactly an empty node here. Then that is a standing wave. And the other closed end is a node. The curve in black, right, those two are the instant where the standing wave is at the maximum displacement, say to the right. And then coming down, this is to the left. The red curve that is moving up and down is the actual displacement at that instant. Then I also need you to sketch the change in pressure wave, again on page 10. Notice that the molecules right here, okay, if you take a look at the molecule close to the node molecules are not moving, but the neighboring molecules are moving towards it. Okay, so at this instant, the pressure is high. You can see the pressure is going up, it's high. Then when the molecules are moving away from the closed end, which is the node, the pressure will decrease. Get further and further away, further and further apart, therefore the pressure now will decrease to the lowest. So the change in the pressure is the largest at the empty node. But the change for pressure at the empty node is the minimum, okay, because they are always spaced out. So there's hardly any variation in pressure.
So we call this a pressure note. A pressure note corresponds to a displacement anti note. So this is a displacement note, it corresponds to a pressure anti note. So the curve that you need to sketch on page 10 will be opposite of what you see here. Or you can change the direction of the tube, the closed end tube. Okay? You just redraw the tube. Because the one that I give you in your lesson, this end is closed. When you redraw the tube, then the graph will be like this. So I'll give you some time to sketch the graph. Similarly, right, if you are given the length of the tube, you can work out what is the wavelength and then work out what is the frequency for mode 1. Then you can go to mode 2. Okay, I'm going to higher mode. This is fundamental, so first harmonic. So if I go to a higher mode, this is what you see on page 11. Okay, but the closed end is the other side now. Okay, so you can see that the displacement of the molecule is 0. When it's at the closed end. Okay, when it's at the open end, it must be an antinode. Then a standing wave is formed. Okay, if you don't have an antinode at the open end, then a standing wave is not formed. Okay, so this is the condition. In your page 11, right, I've given you the displacement. Actually, the waveform that you see inside a tube, that is a displacement distance graph. Then the change in pressure distance graph is just the other way around. We just flip. Vertical inversion. If you turn to page 12, okay, similarly, it's still talking about the tube, but on page 12 is an example whereby you have both sides open. So I can change the end condition to both sides open so there isn't a node at the two ends. Because when it's an open end, it is a free end. Free end means molecules can oscillate. So when a standing wave is formed, I will get antinode at the end and the other end. So this is the first overtone, which is the second harmonic. I can go lower. So this is the fundamental one. Okay, this one you see on page 12. Similarly, I can find the wavelength and then I can find the frequency. Okay, so on page 12, there is a checkpoint. Same like before, I would like you to form for an open pipe of length L. What is the wavelength and the allowed frequency for N harmonics? So I'll give you a minute to do that. Similarly, you look at the pattern. There's another checkpoint on 11, and so page 11 and page 12, you form the equation, the expressions for N harmonics. Page 11 is a closed tube, closed pipe. So one end open, one end closed.
The other one, page 12, is an open pipe, so both ends are open. Okay, so you do both, page 11 and page 12. Done? Similar to what we have done just now for the string. So we look for pattern. Okay, for the closed pipe, that means one end open, one end closed. You can see that the fundamental mode 1, L is 1 quarter lambda. When it's mode 2, L is 3 quarter lambda. When it's mode 3, L is 5 quarter lambda. So what about N? N mode? It will be 2N plus 1 minus 1. Because when N equals to 1, it's 1 quarter. When N equals to 2, it's 3 quarter. When N equals to 3, it is 5 quarter lambda. So when it's N harmonics, it will be 2N minus 1. Okay, so that is the expression that you should get from observing the pattern, and therefore the wavelength for N harmonics will be given by 4L over 2N minus 1. Okay, once you have this expression, to find the frequency, you just use V equal F lambda. So this is the frequency for N harmonics. One end open, one end closed. Can I move on? Okay, then we look at checkpoint on page 12. Similarly, you look for pattern. This one is an open pipe, so two end, both ends are open. L is half lambda 1 for first harmonic. Second harmonic, L is 2 lambda over 2. Third harmonics, L is 3 lambda over 2. So this is similar to the both end closed one. This is now the fixed end one. Okay, so actually you only have two category of equations. So this one is same as the string with two ends fixed. Okay, so the frequency and wavelength, right, for two ends fixed, closed end, or two ends open, they are the same in order to form standing wave. But if you have one end fixed, the other end open, then the frequency will be different. If you notice, those with two ends closed and two ends open, two ends closed will be referring to the transverse example whereby I have a string fixed at both ends. They have all range of frequency for the different harmonic. They have F1, 2, 3, 4. Where F2 is 2 times F1, F3 is 3 times S1, then 4 times F1, and so far so on. But for the closed end, that means one end open, one end closed, you only have the odd number. If you look at mode 1, this is F1. Mode 2 is 3 F1. Then mode 3 is 5 F1. So these are the odd harmonics. In your lecture notes, for the transverse wave, right, the string, I only give you two ends open. They can also test you one end open, one end closed, or two ends open. So the formula is the same as what we have for longitudinal. Okay, so they can be applied across. Okay, for some of you who play instruments, here are some examples of both end opens and you have the open pipe and the closed pipe. Okay, this one here, this group here is the both end open, and the group below is one end open, one end closed. So when you are using this instrument, you are actually producing standing wave.
I have a toy. This is a tube. I can call this a pipe. Okay, where both ends are open. Okay, you can see there's nothing closing it here. Nothing closing on the other side. So the challenge here is, I need someone to come down, use this pipe to produce steady wave. Anyone?
On this class,
other class don't have one here.
Only S for me. Any others like to try?
Oh, I have two here actually. Okay, your name in class?
I'm Mitchell from Indian.
Anthony from EDS 51.
Okay. So, do you all know what to do?
Yeah.
You need to produce standing wave using this prototype. Okay, so remember there is first harmonic, second harmonic, third harmonic, and so on. So I would like you to start with low frequency, and then slowly go to the first harmonic, second harmonic, and let's see how high you go up to.
Everybody can see this. We
all do
together.
Wow, what harmony is that?
Examples here, example 3, as well as example on page 13, I have example 3, example 4. But I think we will just stop here. Okay, you try it out, I'll see you on week 10. So we stop.
Hey, are you all doing justice to my slinky?
Yeah, we're bringing the good news.
Huh? Live? Huh? Yeah, you can explain to the class the different form of slinky.
Look at this.
Okay,